Hi there, welcome back to my channel, Ticking Together. The goal of this channel is to raise awareness about and to educate people on what it's like to live with Tourette syndrome. In today's video, I will be talking all about how I was diagnosed and the lengthy process it took to get to the diagnosis of Tourette syndrome. It all started back when I was 10. Honestly, it started way back when I was born, but the real juicy stuff starts when I was 10. I was always an anxious child, a perfectionist, trying to make sure that everything was always okay. I was always asking questions, wondering what if and why this and why that, you know? And I don't remember the exact reason, but I think that just getting older and nearing puberty, I was becoming more and more worried. I always had something to worry about and was always stressed for some reason. Now, this isn't to say that me being stressed had a cause in my tics or was the main reason my tics started to act up, but I think it did play a part in it. I remember the summer after grade 6 ended, I was just becoming progressively more worried. My family and my friends noticed, and they were getting more and more concerned for me. I think it was my mom or my dad who first noticed my tics, and they noticed even before I did. My first real tic was blinking my eyes really hard, and now that I'm talking about it, I'm gonna have to do it. But I would blink my eyes so hard, and my family thought maybe I was just having vision problems. So after going to the eye doctor and coming back with 20/20 vision, at the time, I know I have glasses now, we ruled out the vision problems. I remember my parents and extended family would be like, "What are you doing?" Every time I blinked my eyes hard, they would be like, "What are you doing? Please stop." And I just couldn't, and I didn't even notice it. A vivid memory I have was my dad getting a laptop for the first time and me being 11, just being obsessed with the webcam. I would make little videos of myself, kind of like I'm doing now, just talking and goofing off. When I'd watch them back, I'd be so confused watching the person who I was, watching me blinking so hard on camera after filming, not even realizing that I was doing it. I was like, what the heck, am I doing that? Like, really? I had become so used to it that I had no idea that this blinking was weird or uncommon. Soon after, I started my nose scrunching tic, which was subtle enough, but I began to notice these two in my webcam videos, and my parents became concerned again. Throughout this time, I also had coughing tics and throat clearing tics, and I would also make little sounds that my whole family thought was just a joke, and I did too. But it got to the point where other body parts were getting involved too, not just my face. I would flick my wrists up and down and kick my feet together when I walked, and it was really getting concerning, and everyone in my family was noticing. Everyone I knew was telling me to stop and asking me why I couldn't stop, and I didn't know. I just couldn't. I remember there was a conversation between my parents and my aunts and uncles, and they were telling them about how I was doing all these weird things with my face. And my one aunt mentioned Tourette syndrome to my mom. My older cousin had Tourette's, and I didn't know much about it, and honestly, I didn't really talk to my cousin because he was so much older than me. So my aunt had told my mom that these things I was doing with my face, they were tics. I remember hearing this conversation from my parents and just being like so scared. Being 10 or 11, I remember Googling Tourette's and just being like, what? There's no way. I didn't want to have a diagnosis. I didn't want to be weird. I didn't want to be different. I did not want to deal with this. I wanted to stop blinking. I wanted to stop scrunching my nose. I wanted to stop coughing. I just wanted to end the whole thing. I remember seeing things on Google that scared me a lot. I saw a lot about how Tourette's makes people swear, and that scared me to death because as a little 11-year-old, I had never said a bad word in my life, and I thought, is this gonna start to make me swear? Like, I don't get it. I thought that if I got diagnosed with Tourette's that I would start swearing and that basically I would go crazy. Another thing I saw online were all of these like pre-meme time memes that were called Tourette's Guy, and they were just basically this picture of this guy with just all of this like gross obscene stuff surrounding him and just basically mocking Tourette's and being like, this is not something you want to have, especially as an 11-year-old. Basically, I saw a lot of things that a little 11-year-old trying to get information should not have seen because it just made me really scared. I remember coming across the Wikipedia page for Tourette's and reading how blinking your eyes really hard, coughing and throat clearing, and scrunching your nose were all really common starting tics. At this point, after reading it all, I was terrified, but I kind of had a hunch that maybe this is what I was dealing with. And being the worried kid I was just constantly thinking about the what ifs, what's gonna happen to me, what's wrong with me, and the whys. Why am I dealing with this? My next step was to see a pediatrician. My mom took me to the doctor and we talked about all of my tics. Honestly, I don't remember a lot because it was so long ago, but I do know that he said that I had to have at least 2 motor tics and 1 vocal tic for a period of 3 months until I could be diagnosed with Tourette's. And at this point, I had had all the qualifications and I just wanted some answers. The rest is a little blurry because, like I said, it was so long ago. I'm 22 years old now, but I remember the pediatrician wanted to send me to a psychiatrist in order to get the official diagnosis. I remember hearing that actually having Tourette's was almost a relief because I'd been developing more tics and I just wanted an answer. It was kind of calming to know that these weird movements and sounds that I was making were known by doctors and the diagnosis actually had a name. But I remember also feeling really sad because I felt like I'd never be normal Carly again. I'd always be Carly with Tourette's. And I remember I didn't want anyone to know. I didn't want to tell anybody because I was ashamed. By this point, I knew I most likely wouldn't wake up and start swearing one day, but I was also so terrified and just didn't want people to know because I knew that there was such a negative stigma around it and that there were so many mean people who were gonna maybe judge me. I wanted my tics to get better, but they would get a lot worse before they would even get remotely better. The psychiatrist was the first one to verify my Tourette syndrome diagnosis, and then came all the hard stuff, like the treatments and medication. And this was all really hard for the brain of a 12-year-old to comprehend. But after talking to all these doctors, they made me realize that I had had Tourette syndrome my whole life and that my blinking wasn't even my first tic. My mom remembers me having tics with my legs and arms as early as 3 years old. And it's just kind of crazy that they started getting so out of hand in my junior high years. I guess that's the end of the story, how I found out that I had Tourette's. But there's a lot more to my story than just the diagnosis part. I will continue to post videos on this channel answering questions and telling my story in hopes that maybe I will spread awareness, educate, and maybe make someone who's in my shoes feel a little bit less alone. Thank you for listening to my story, and if you can, I would love it if you gave this video a thumbs up, left a comment letting me know what you want to see or just saying hi, and subscribe to my channel if you want to hear more content from me talking all about my journey with Tourette syndrome. Bye guys.